that anyone really wins. It's just so hard to time for it, right? There's no back and forth. There's no fairness, it feels like, when it's a three-way fight. Someone always has to win the floor of instead.
Yeah, I think this is one of those situations that we keep talking about, the routines of the frame of their ground. The fight doesn't necessarily have to break out there. You can maybe just take things a bit slower. Pablo definitely be able to take things slower, isn't it? He's taking a bit of damage there. Do it 1-2. Just north of Red Jump, where we are right now. Last game should have finished in this area, but as we start here, Pablo will put a nice little shot on Samurka. Red Jump, he gives it the most optimal angle, but he looks good used to it there. And this is really nice. Looking for some control, making sure that they have the exit control as well on the pieces. They're doing really well with this left on top of the game. Murder and Ligon just getting absolutely wrangled there. The flag will pick up one. And so in a 2v1, Pablo hit the two shot, but he actually goes down. So now we're down to a 1v1. Murder has done brilliantly there. Oh dear. Flag, what can he do? All alone, we have time to get the ready. See, what's the action?
This is such a lopsided kind of fight. Like, not getting a finish on that ball player. At the same time, 2v1. But what is it going to pop? This thing should be happening. Now that Rez has to be staked in. There's no time to get off of it. The 50-50 mind games back and forth. The kickoff's coming in 3 seconds. The slack is looking through. Pablo, is it staying alive? This shouldn't even be alive.
I don't know how he's done it. He's gotten the red off. It's Elijah. He's doing a brilliant job to keep his team in this one. Now not looking too good. It's a good shot there, but ultimately it was such low key. Swag and Pablo will deal with him. The Flames boys come away with the win here. And that's exactly what they were coming in to do. Maybe made it a bit more difficult for them, John. But ultimately, the most important thing is that they win it.
On the board, 6-1 in, and on the line, Rykoff took their 6th place overall coming into this game. And I'm always doing my double checking on the side. You can literally just see 2-6 about Rykoff. I'm going to drop the whole hat, man. This is so convenient. I love it. And there's still going to be pressure. This is the one thing I like about teams in the lead, but you know, you don't change how you're playing entirely. Especially during the midpoint of the competition. You see some experienced teams come in, doing these MTSs, they get first overall in the first few games at 11, and then they just change things up entirely. You don't think it's passes, and they wonder, why did the games change? Where are our points going? Not the same team that got first in the first few games.
This is one of those situations where, you know, you got a lot of these teams who really want to try and make sure that they're going to get a successful team again. Take a look at some of the replays. They've got the Joneses, things going down. Really expect anything else. Some good shot. I'm sure this guy took a moment as well. Striking around to close things out. And that's the thing with this team can't really do it now, right? It's going to be so beautiful. Doing that music sound.
Three as well. The chuck missed a lot of players. It's maybe the last time they try a certain strat before going on the back end key plan B, so things might be even more desperate overall. Maybe this is why Lifeline Milano are really trying to push people around their spot, right? If they win a fight a third time in a row, it might be a signal for the enemy team they're facing to choose a completely different spot, and now they have the back half of the competition bolstered up, an entire POI being set on houses, chesting out the floor to go even further. Who knows the big shot? Because he's got all the way down in the basement.
Yeah, this is nice. You can see Rafa and Milano taking up different positions either side of these two, forcing them to make a decision as they look to pinch the win. Milano starting to pull up the games. Play it slowly in the meantime. And Milan, he's one of the better players as well in this game so far. Rafa moving by his side. Milan's going to keep the grip. Taking a bit too long for their liking. And then getting a little bit to the key, we need to see another one.
Something I'm liking a lot about this new map is the introduction of a lot of spots like this. You might not have name crew wise entirely, but you have a lot of base camps set up that have somewhat of, you know, henchman type chests and buffed up chests at the same time, campfires. You have a spreading of coolers on the map as well as the fire boxes. Lots of ways we can get the game started with, you know, off spawners and whatnot too. But I wanted an inside though to easy and heavy. And Sleepy Sound looking really good for them overall. I feel like anyone that starts off in this spot level has a certain huge advantage over everyone else.
Yeah, this pretty much great. Right? They're able to get max materials, a really good chunk of metal atmosphere while it can be a problem for some teams. They can't leave if they want to live with us, particularly if they're stuck for the game, so I'll see if they'll get that one. Often leaving the peppers as well, and as you can see, Freezy's got some peppers, plenty of cookies boxes over to this and they'll try to the one thing I will say though, right, if you have worked on your past set games, they have often struggled with more southern games. And as you can see, they are heading to the south of the game. So you see how our third play team does, which is deep emphasizing in that little break there how important it is, right, to see two things on, which is important to the actual preparation that goes into it. Especially early on in the second CS, we are seeing that when teams don't choose to always play with each other's DOIs, it can be a bit of a struggle there as they try to traverse the rotate through. It's only going to get more difficult in these second CS lobbies, so we'll see how teams deal with that. This one is one of the games which probably will encourage teams to go to the table. I've been thinking about how certain games mean that, you know, maybe the third players have a bit more isolated and tilted without any teams interfering. But in this one, we're going to expect a lot of teams to be coming through here. And I think Coach 2 is going to be one of them.
Well, nothing can go wrong if you're just rotating through Coco first. Like, surely, there's not going to be a disaster that happens when you're in one of the hottest spots in the map that everyone has to rotate through. It's very good to stay here for as long as possible and not move out for the POI. Giving someone doesn't know exactly what I'm talking about. So quickly, they move towards the outskirts. And on the left side as well, how I like the shot to back down the rocky road. It feels like I'm having deja vu from the first game and how this one goes. And that's the base level. I mean, Phoenix Horizon, it's paradise for me.
Yeah, look, for a lot of those more teams, they would be happy to get it through all the way south, right? If you have a game that pulls back far south for the first zone, typically you would expect it maybe to pull a bit further down, but fortunately, it needs to be up in the middle there. And so, it's a bit more than even playing for the team around the map. It's a technical difficulty area. Things happen.
One thing I've noticed
in
the Phoenix Horizon as well is that they're very on guard duo 24-7. A lot of the times when you see a few duos play, they have many for the effort guard down, but they don't maybe build as much. They don't invest too much in the way they are, or they stay maybe at 75 or 50 shield to see if they get a siphon or any extra greed along the way. They're on guard a lot, which makes it so that they are a little bit less resourceful the entire time. They don't have, you know, a full inventory to see right now. They're matched up and down entirely. But it feels like playing the ultimate defense level is working out really well for them the first two games.
Yeah, I think, you know, a little bit is sometimes of how, you know, they're able to play these games out and make sure the decision-making that they make. But they've done a decent job thus far with our first game. Really nice sort of, you know, let's keep going off the first. Second game is a bit more of a struggle. But for the meantime, we still have options. Like you sort of alluded to, though, it's not the benefits right now. They're going to need a reset. They're going to need to do something to get them to see that not many options in terms of farming potential right now around them. And so they're going to have to make some sort of repair to at some point. Maybe they're not just looking to now, but hopefully it builds and heal it. Not going to be going to moving forward.
And the play stocks down, I feel like before they're also tagging along on side points to many different fights and coming in and cleaning up after the fact. This time they're absolutely low ground. They're surrounded by bills and buildings. They also don't have a say as much in this game. Talking about a say though, Hen for the moment is not dictating how this lobby gets to play. 8-4 Elims throughout the day right now. That is a huge number for a, you know, final round plus qualifier lobby. That's like something that's not usually common for every player to have. And for him, I mean, you go high ground, what, level 3 in a row, it has to be the game, right?
Yeah, and look, the league has been leading the way for him. It's the excellent direction. And the biggest fear with this duo, with any duo that Freezy brings, as much as he's a brilliant mind, will there be enough firepower in the duo for them to be successful? And I think with him, there's no doubt about that. But, look, We're gonna have to do a touch. I hope you get it. See if you're wrong on it. You can see the idea behind it right now, realizing that inside the zone, not going to be many players in the facility. You can take a bit of an isolated fight against them to find show that we're going to deal with ourselves with you. And this is really nice because they're just taking that whole front down. Now they're actually going to use the things that are put down in the show that's put down to pinch their way in. Oh, this is beautiful. Look at the 17, distracting them. 10 coming from the back, kicks 31. Would have wanted a bit more, but this is brilliant. Amplify down. Play that's now left alone. Oh, this is what we're talking about right now, Simon.
This is just ridiculous. I haven't seen it pinch like that. That slow thought out from the mental system of working. See that new wave just shot teams. You just end up landing in, not knowing exactly what they're doing. Look at the seasoned veteran of Amplify. They got absolutely fearless in that circumstance, in that aspect. That is just crazy. Confusing ahead. They just locked it down. We're talking about probably the first 50% above now. They're just here in chaos looking. They were not waiting for a single moment.
I love it. You saw the intention there. You saw him sneak it up and around. You knew what he was doing. I'm sure we all would have wanted to be in his position ready to just put the finger on the trigger and move. You can see now from being below inside 327 above. There's plays like that, right, that can just really sort of shoot you out. But you saw how creative they got and how successful it was in the end. A beautiful play. Now, we're going to have to see something beautiful for Horizon or Phoenix. If they just look to take a standard box fight, you can lose, but in these sort of environments, they get really difficult. 33 above, they won't be satisfied until they see if they can do a bit more damage, because here the other players looking to use shields, so they know they're low. There is a bit of a ticking time in there.
Specifically there right now, even if you put it in time, sir, you didn't call your health bar. It kind of looks like the main issue for them is their health bar. You guys can't really see it and look like one at the moment. It's their resources overall. Missing a few inventory slots. You tuned out with them, they had about 58 full of bills on Phoenix. Now it's down to 38. So they are dwindling on that aspect fast. And you could be 100 and 100. You could be 700 and 700 shields and health even, right? But if you don't have materials, you don't have weapons to cut back ammunition, shields, it doesn't matter. The lobby will eat you alive. So those maps, very important. Now Phoenix, you start to run away. Ryzen actually leading everything. You look at this building, you can't pop everything out supremely. The metal will be everlasting time. There's opportunity to find inside, except for a few vending machines and boxes, and get maybe plus 4, plus 5 for them. But be able to just, the wooden top off completely. Cortex and Genesis, you can have a DKS in the air on this, and it's really a Spider-Man mishap, and it's Kenny and Tika hit the loop from them, which is crazy. Is that a mythic MK7?
Yes, it is. And they think it's a good use as well. We talked about how they've done a decent job of being able to get some eliminations so far in this game, 6-3 effectively. Well, I'm not going to put that still. I think they're going to put that to their use. It's funny because we're already on the map. Basically, we just have a map to right? This is sort of the general area of their strip. You look at some of the things in this tree actually here. Doing well to hold up with the strap. Really not good stuff. Way too. Look at
that firepower, look at it all. I thought I was watching a trash compactor, but I thought that was kind of messy. The balls are on the whole ground, on the walls all around them. Even though they're lethal, they're a full fire force. I feel like a lot of the fights we're starting to watch in like game 3, maybe even game 4, might be a little bit too desperate, not as organized. But then also, we saw the hand easy pinch breakdown. That was just great. Definitely some teams. Still in control. Kriyachi needs to find some Magnus, a medkit, something somewhere, because they're going to even have to fly. It looks like, no, for now, just run into a zone. It might just be about 50, 60 meters overall, but with, what, 10, 20 teams around them, even one little mishap will just have that HP bar to beat
it. Yeah, just going to get a rough one. We've been pretty consistent this far, sitting in 6 places, you can see, so we're going to keep that up, but like you said, it's going to be an uphill battle. Again, right, you keep emphasizing this stuff, but still, it is all about resource management to a degree, and so we don't have those resources. All you've got to do is, all you're spending your time thinking about, I should say, is how you can get there, and how you can put yourself in a position cheaper to make it through some of the most difficult goals to be able to get.
when you do some uphill battle, when is a downhill start? Is it even a hill that we're talking about right now? Because it just seems like some of these teams never get to enjoy the, you know, wee part of the roller coaster when you're going down. They're just going up forever with complete anxiety.
Very, very difficult. It's a kind of a speed up on that hill. Going to get the
that'd be the worst ride, dude. Just imagine only going up and then having to just, I don't know, walk down. That's what it feels like for some of these teams. Let's see that perspective. Just the upward roller coaster. The hill got a finish on the rise and he's going to get the side feet. That's just beating. That's how it happens. For the same low key, everything looks absolutely disastrous. And you're like, hey, let's just pad in on some boys. Get the leap.
But that's what you talk about, right? In terms of being able to make those kind of power plays. And that right there was a brilliant power play. And finally, team, caught unawares, confined to just what, one, two boxes, they got in. And you know that this season, the striker can do two players coming at you with that. It can be a very difficult to deal with. And so, they're barely above themselves, but they can do it, so you know that. It's the biggest advantage for them now is the fact that they're looking really good on the material. Phoenix there, 147 builds, really maxed out. That's where they want to be right now.
I think animation might be an issue though, but the mind is a bit split as well.